Use headphones for best experience. Thanks for your fantastic support, and thank you for supporting me on Jingles and Patreon. Hi. Welcome to another video. And this is going to be another map drawing video. I will try to draw the map of Westeros from the Game of Thrones. And I'll use this piece of paper that I have prepared a little bit. It is a black paper, but I put some white and green and blue ink on it. Painted it a bit like a ground. I'll start as usual with the coastline. And Westeros. Oh, yeah. Before I start, I would like to show you something. Did you know that Västerås is actually a city in Sweden? I'll zoom in a bit so you can see. This is an old map. It's showing how the Kingdom of Sweden looked like in the medieval times, 1380 to 1560, it says here. Here you can see Västerås, spelled almost like the Västerås continent in Game of Thrones, but with the O letter instead of the O letter. That's how we write the sound O in Swedish. We don't use the O for that sound, we use this letter O. It's actually a big city in Sweden, the fifth biggest. I'll show you another map as well. This is a map from 1895. Here you can see it's spelled a little different. With the single V instead of W, it's Västerås. Like I said, it's the fifth biggest city, has 120,000 people living there today, and it's quite close to Stockholm, the capital city. Only 100 kilometers or 62 miles. And this city was founded in 990, so it's an old city. Changed the spelling over the years. Today it's spelled with the A instead of the E here, it's the second letter. It also has a nickname, it's called the Gurk. Staden. That's the cucumber city. But don't worry, I'm not going to draw the city of Västerås today. Maybe I can do that in the future, someday. But today it's the continent of Westeros. So if we start with the coastline here, it's quite narrow around something called the Neck. Just start to draw quite lightly. Then I'll go on with some markers. On the southern part of the continent, in the north. And north of the wall we have something called the land. Always winter. This is just a quick start. Share mistakes while I'm drawing with the markers. We have the Iron Islands. Some of them. And the reed. Stormlands. I think it reminds me of Wales. The shape, but mirrored. And the Crownlands. I'm not sure if this will help me, maybe. I think it's a good start here with the Neck. And, let's draw the eastern coast here. Something called the Fingers. Very mountainous area. Actually, it should be five fingers here. One, just like a hand. One, two, three, four, five. Something that looks like a fjord. There are a lot of islands around this continent, so I guess I will be using this blue color a lot for this video. And here here, Dragonstone, small but important island. Here we have the Stormlands. Now I'm a bit worried I won't have enough room for that door. Maybe I'll have to squeeze it down. The shape of the most southern part here. Scale it down. To have room for this peninsula called Dorne and the Broken Arm. So some historically important islands, the Stepstones, archipelago to the south east. I guess there were enough room here. Lot of small bays. The south west, still think of Great Britain when I see this, but it's mirrored. And London would be here somewhere. Mm-hmm. biggest lake in the continent here. Somewhere. I think I should place it here. God's Eye and a small island in the middle, the Isle of Faces. And I'll go on with the west coast here. Westerlands. Some islands. And a big collection of islands here, like Pelago, the Iron Island. A lot of history. I'm a bit worried. It's not enough space for the entire north. Yeah, I think it is, but I will not have so much room for the area beyond the wall this time. Maybe in another. Would be nice to draw continent of Essos as well someday. But most important is that I have room for the wall, I guess. And I have. So there we have it. The continent of Westeros. Show you the entire map later, but as for now, I'll move the paper like this because I think it's better that you can see what I'm writing and drawing. I think it's interesting with the roads, so I think I'll start with the roads on this map and to. I'll use the yellow color for that. The major roads, there aren't so many. The capital is located here at King's Landing, and many roads starting from King's Landing. Maybe not a surprise. South all the way through the north. Takes a little turn here. Continues to the middle of the wall here, Castle Black, the middle of the wall. And here we have a lot of roads crossing. Road to the Vale. It's the river road through the Riverlands. Capital of Westlands, and here also the, one of the biggest cities on the continent, the Lannisport. From Lannisport to King's Landing, there's another road called the, is it Rose? No, sorry, Gold Road. They meet here at Casterly Rock. Then we have a road following the coast here, it's a sea road, or also called ocean road. Meets up here with another road called the Rose Road, going through the reef. This is an extension of the King's Road. To the Storm's End. And then we have this road called the Bone Way. Two passageways into the Dorn. One is the Bone Way, the other one is Prince's Path. It's located here. This is really a mountainous area. I'll draw the mountains soon. here, Rhodes, I'd like to add. For the mountains, I'd like to use this yellow-orange color. The red mountains separates the reach from the Dorn, making the Dorn quite isolated place. The entire Westerlands is very mountainous, except this peninsula, I guess. These are called the Western Hills. Westerlands a very rich, wealthy region. But there is one region even more mountainous, the Vale. The Vale of Arryn, actually named after the only part of the region that's not mountainous. It's a valley, vale here. There's the mountains of the moon. And here's the fingers. See, I forgot the three islands I'd like to add here. Sheep's Head Hills, just like one hill here, or one mountain, and also the Lonely Hills, but then we have the Northern Mountain. Side of the wall, we have the Frost Fangs. You can only see the most southern part of it here. Now I'll go on with some forest. Big forest here north of the neck, or actually the neck is a big forest. Or like a swamp. And then another big forest to the north, is a wolf's wood. So this is supposed to be trees. South, there aren't as much forest as in the north. I guess it used to be, but much of it has been cut down. The forest used to be where the children of the forest lived. When they were sharing this continent together with the first men and the giants. This is the king's wood. This is rain wood. And these two forests used to be one big forest. Some desert here to the south, the Dorn. This is supposed to be sand. I think the Dorn is the less populated area. Whole continent. It's really dry, a lot of desert. Time for the rivers, and I haven't decided if I would use a darker blue color or a more light blue, but I think I'll start with the darker one. I think it could be nice on this map. Most important river, I think, Starting here. Yeah, it's clearly visible. Separates into three forks here in the riverlands. Green fork leading all the way to up to the neck and the swamps here. Starting in these mountains in the Westerlands. And then we have a river from this God's Eye. Ending here in Blackwater Bay. There's a really small island here in the river where it meets the bay. It's a quiet isle. The Blackwater Rush. And we have a river here as well, short river, and also a river here, the Kingswood, and also a little bridge here over where the King's Road meets this river. It's called the Wendwater. The Wendwater Bridge. And I'd like to point out two rivers in the Dorne. It's a Brimstone and Green Blood. Mander River. It's like a system of rivers here. Starting here in the Red Mountains, and some starting here in the Western Hills. Yeah, we have the Torrentine River, also in the Dorne. The Red Mountain. And some minor rivers here. Close to Old Town. to the north. It's a system of swamps and rivers here. The neck has a really interesting history, this area. I guess that's a physical map of Westeros, south of the wall. And next I would like to add some capitals of regions. Yeah, I would like to draw the borders of the regions. It's called the Seven Kingdoms, at least historically. It used to be seven kingdoms, separate kingdoms. And now it's like united to one kingdom, consisting of nine regions. This light red for the border. Let's start in the south. So I mentioned this area here, the region called the Dorne. This is the Dorne. Then we have the Stormlands. The Dornish Marches is an area here between the Reach, the Stormlands, and the Dorne. It's a disputed area. There's been a lot of wars and fighting. Claim this area. But now it's part of the Stormlands. On this map. Here's the relatively new border between Stormlands and King's Landing. King's Landing used to be part of the Stormlands, the Storm Kings, before Aegon the Conqueror arrived here. see, I have forgotten important island called Tarth outside the coast of the Stormlands. Sapphire Island. Okay, I'll go on with the Crownlands. Region here, the reach, reaching all the way to the Gold Road. No, sorry, that was a mistake actually. Through this forest, it's not, the reach doesn't reach all the way to the Gold Road, it reaches to the Rose Road. That's what I wanted to show you, but I can fix this mistake again using dark. Westerlands, basically all this mountainous area. And the Iron Island, its own region. The Riverlands and the Vale. Also basically all these mountains plus this valley. And between the Riverlands and the north, just across the neck, and then border for the whole kingdom, the wall and the gorge. Next, I'd like to add Westerns are mostly castles, not cities. In the Dorne, we have the castle of Sunspear. Castle High Garden. Here where both these two roads meet and also these two rivers meet. Strategically good location, I guess. Casterly Rock in the Westerland. And then we have the capital of the whole kingdom, and also the biggest city, it's King's Landing. Castle, because it's on the giant's lands, really steep cliff. So it's really impregnable, and it's called the Eyrie, located here in the mountains. So the road ends here in the Bloody Gate. I'd like to point out some major cities. And for that I'll use a white pen. Well, this is like a correction pen, not an actual pen. Small town called Shadow City here somewhere. Yeah, I'll use this color as well for castles, that's not capitals. I'd like to point out Hellholt. Second biggest city in the whole continent is Old Town. It used to be the capital before King's Landing. And then we have the biggest city in the Westerlands, Lannisport, just south of the Casterly Rock. So here somewhere it should be. And I'd like to point out Harrenhal, a bit north to the lake, God's Eye. And also in the Iron Islands. There aren't really any cities, but I guess Harlow is the most populated island, but there are no cities there. But there is something called the Lord's Port, the same island as the Pike. So I guess I point that out. In the Vale, we have Gull Town located here. I think it's the fourth biggest city in the whole kingdom. Sister Town, located on one of these three sisters. Islands. In the north, we have the fifth biggest city, White Harbor, by the White Knife River. And just south Winterfell, we have Wintertown. And this area to the north, the very north here of the kingdom, is called the Gift. Maybe I should some borders for that. It's kind of a region supposed to defend the kingdom, defend the wall. And Molestown is located within the Shadow Tower at the very west, here, next to the gorge. Over the gorge, it's actually a bridge. I would like to point out some more castles and towns in the Riverland. So two castles called the Twins on each side of the Green Fork, the bridge over the river. Old Stones is a castle along the Blue Fork with a lot of interesting history. Fair Market is quite a large town next to the Blue Fork. And maybe I could point out this Inn of the Crossroads. Where all these these roads meet, there's an inn. That I guess is quite important. This little island here is called Fair Isle. There's Fair Castle. Is the most populated region, but actually there aren't so many cities because there are people living everywhere. It's a fertile farming area here, one of the richest areas. The only reason that the Westerland is more wealthy or rich is because of the gold, otherwise it should be the rich. This is also where the first man first settled. And they arrived here from Essos. And there was a land bridge. It wasn't a broken arm like this, it was land. So they walked here. Didn't settle like here. Torn because it was, well, not so good for farming or for anything. It was just desert, so they went here and started in the agriculture civilization. This was like 12,000 years ago. Seven kingdoms. So before that, Hungarians and Aegon the Conqueror came here. There were like seven old kingdoms, and this was called the Principality of Dorne. The Kingdom of the Reach, and this was the Kingdom of the Stormlands, and the borders were a little different then, because this region didn't exist. And then we had the Kingdom of the Rock, what's now Westeros. Maybe the border was a bit different here to the north, because what's now the Iron Islands used to be the kingdom of the isles and rivers. I guess they had a lot of land here as well, the mainland. It's a big kingdom. They built the Harrenhal Castle. That was just finished. Same day that Aegon the Conqueror came here and destroyed it. Then we have Kingdom of the Mountain and the Vale. What's now the Vale of Arryn? And the Kingdom of the North. And sometimes I write on the maps as well, but lately I found that it becomes too blurry and messy. So maybe I'll just write the names of the seas surrounding the continent. So here we have the Narrow Sea. Westeros and Essos to the east, the other continent in the known world, and south of Westeros we have the Summer Sea. West of Westeros we have the Sunset Sea. This is the Iron Man Bay. This is called the Bight. To the north, it's called the Shivering Sea. This is a bay. Seals. This is Bear Island, and this is the Bay of Ice. This is the frozen shore, and the land of all is winter. But no one knows how far north it extends. An area that I find interesting and mysterious is west of Westeros. Maybe I should add, actually, there are some islands. It's part of the Iron Islands. Actually, I have just drawn 8 islands here, but there are actually 31 of them here, and then there are 14 more, like 8 days, if you're sailing for 8 days to the west, you'll reach the next couple of islands. Only one of them is inhabited. It's called the Lonely Light, but it feels like I should include it somehow. Basically just a rock. see, I forgot. Four small islands here. The Shield Island. This is called the Arbor, and between the Arbor and the Reach, I mean, the Arbor is part of the Reach, but this sound here is called the Red Wine Straits. And they produce a lot of wine in this area, in the Reach, but the best wine is from the Arbor. So, I guess this is what I wanted to draw today. Now, it's time to zoom out so you can see the whole map. So, this is my map of Westeros. Hope you like and enjoy the video. I would like to thank you for all my new subscribers to this channel. The last video I uploaded, the drawing map of USA, was really popular, and I'm so grateful and happy that you watch it and that has been recommended to many new viewers. I've had a lot of new subscribers. You're so welcome. Love to see you here. And I hope you will like my upcoming videos in the future. And thank you so much for all the suggestions and requests. I actually asked you for requests about drawing US states. And I hope this didn't upset you, because after all the requests I got, over like 1200, I think it's like crazy how many requests, when there were only 50 states you could choose between. But I got a lot of requests for nations and states and countries outside the US as well, and that's completely fine. I will not only draw US states in the future, but I got some really nice suggestions, and I will start to do some of those eventually. But then I also got this request from Finn Sharp, from Baking Cookies, from Connor McMullen, and from Fear the XI, that you wanted to see a map of Westeros and Essos, or one of those continents. And then I felt like, yeah, if I should ever do that, I should do it now. So that's why I started with this. Sorry, I just noticed I forgot one of the capitals, and that's Storm's End. Located here in Stormland. And that is also an interesting history, because they had to, I can write the name of this bay here, Shipbreaker. And there's so many storms and heavy, really heavy ones here. So they had to build 6 castles that were destroyed by the storm before finally they built the storms and that could last. So I hope you enjoyed this video, that you found it relaxing, and thank you so much for your support, for watching my videos and subscribing, requesting for your suggestions for new videos. And see you soon. Sleep well. Take care.